in search of P time, P like present and past. Today I'll speak about some books of my youth and my parents' youth. Last Saturday, I went with Jules, my boyfriend, to a market of used books in Paris. He goes there often because he's collecting some old books whose collection was directed by André Malraux about art, all kind of periods of art in different civilizations. And Saturday, he bought a book on Egyptian art. As I thought I would look at that book, which was gorgeous, I thought, to be prepared, I'll read myself the chapter on a Gombrich book, very famous, called The Story of Art on Egypt, Old Egypt, and the art usually to accompany dead people, kings or important people. And that sent me back to my mother's favorite book, which was, when she was young, which was The Romance of the Mummy by Théophile Gautier. She pushed me at the time to read it, which I did. And you know, mummies were always popular with children, especially before the time of dinosaur, which apparently overtook mummies in the as a favorite subject for children. So I read that book, it was okay. And mummies came back, and Egyptian princess, when perhaps 25 years ago, with my then husband, Alan, in America, I met a partner of his who was French and whose wife had written and published in a well-known publishing company a book on a romance of an Egyptian princess. So I asked the partner, did your wife sell well the books? Oh, he said, oh yes, she sold hundreds of volumes. I know it because I'm the one who bought them and put them in my basement. So I realized at the time that was not easy to sell books. I bought her book, I read it, and frankly, it was not Proust's writing, to be kind. So my father had also a favorite book of his youth, which was, I think, more well-known because it has been adapted everywhere in cinema, and it's a great adventure called The Three Musketeers by Alexandre Dumas. I read that with more pleasure, but no, it was, I liked it, that's it. So it led me now to a story of book that the narrator in Search of Lost Time read when he was a child. During a very famous scene where the narrator asked for his mother a kiss, good night, and eventually she gives in and goes upstairs to his bedroom and spent the night with him, reading him a book by George Sand, who is also linked to the youth of my mother. As I told you before, she was going on vacation in a village in Berry, and in that village, Saint-Sever-sur-Ain, they mention a lot George Sand, who was the famous writer from the Berry. And the book he mentioned, the narrator mentioned, is François Le Champy. And I'll read one of the texts at the end of In Search of Lost Time, in Time Regained, when he remembers that book a little bit like the Madeleine. If ever in thought I take up François Le Champy in the library, immediately a child rises within me and replaces me, who alone has the right to read that title, François Le Champy, and who reads it as he read it then with the same impression of the weather out in the garden, with the same old dreams about countries and life, the same anguish of the morrow. If I see a thing of another period, another young man will emerge, and my personality of today is only an abandoned quarry which believes that all it contains is uniform and monotonous, but from which memory, like a sculpture of ancient Greece, produces innumerable statues. Time regained.